Good morning, students. We are back with our science period. We have started the lesson number 8, that is skeletal system and nervous system. We have started the lesson, that is skeletal system and nervous system. We have learned the concept of skeletal system. What is exactly the skeletal system? Skeletal system is consist of nothing but bones. Am I right? Which is consist of bones. Bones give the shape and support to our body. It gives shape and support to our body. Then we have learned the main parts of the skeletal system, that is skull, rib cage. Then we have learned about backbone and ribs. And also we have learned about the function of the skeletal system. If you have seen the bones are bifurcated in a different parts, right? They are bifurcated into the different, the bones are of different types. But to join this bone, to meet this bone, we have learned the concept of joints in the last video. Yes or no? Because the bones where the bones are joined by the strong tissue called as ligaments. The bones are joined by the strong tissue, it's called ligaments. Then we have learned about the different types of joint, that is ball and socket joint, hinge joint, pivot joint and gliding joint. Now just in a fraction of a second, can we just recall all the types of the joint? See, just tell me where this ball and socket joint is located. It is located in our shoulder and hip. Then where is your hinge joint is located? See, ball and socket joint can move in all the direction. Your hand can move in all the direction. Then we have learned about hinge joint. Where it is present? In the elbow. Yes or no? Which moves only in one direction. Hinge joint is present in elbow, fingers and in your knee, which moves only in one direction. Then the next step of the joint we have learned about pivot joint, which is present in our neck. It is present in our neck, which can move up, down and side. Then we have learned about gliding joint, which moves slightly. This joint moves only slightly. So this type of the joints we have learned in the last video. So in today's video, we are going to learn about a new concept. Now if you will see our bones, if you will see our skeletal system, which only consists of bones, the another layer is there on this bone that consists of muscles. So in today's topic, we are going to learn about muscles. Which topic we are going to learn today? Muscles and its types of muscles. So but before that, what are actually the muscles? Muscles are the elastic tissue. If you will see the layer above the bone, this is all muscle. Yes or no? This is all muscles. If you will see, it is an elastic tissue, which is made up of elastic tissue. These muscles are attached to the bones. The bone and muscles are attached by the muscles are attached. The muscles are attached to the bones by the strong fiber that is called as a tendons. Which fiber? The muscles and the bones are attached by the strong fiber. Can you just name? Yes, it is nothing but a tendons. There are total 650 muscles in our body. How many muscles do we have? 650 muscles. We have 650 muscles in our body. We have 650 muscles in our body. The muscle helps us the bones to move from one place to another. It helps for the movement. The muscle helps for the movement. It moves our bone. It helps the bones to move. Then the muscles also helps to contract and expand. The muscles always works in a pair. For example, now if you will see your arm muscle, this is your arm, am I right? Now if you will see, you say this is a bicep and this is a, now side it is a tricep. tricep. Which muscle is there? Your bicep, and this is a tricep. When you pull your hands like this, then your bicep contract and tricep get relaxed. Bicep contract and tricep get relaxed. When you stretch your arm, at that time your bicep get contract and your tricep get relaxed. Means in short, the muscles are always in the pair. They are always in the pair. See, if you will consist of your arm, this side is bicep and this is a tricep. When you pull your hands like this, that time your biceps get contract and tricep get relaxed. And when you stretch your arms, at the time bicep get relaxed and tricep get contract. Tricep get contract. So muscles always works in a pair. Now the muscles, according to the function and the structure, the muscles are classified into three types: voluntary, involuntary, and cardiac. Can you just tell me? The muscles are classified into these three types: voluntary, involuntary, and cardiac. Now we will learn them one by one. The first is voluntary muscles. Voluntary muscles, they are under our control. Now see, for example, if I want to stretch my arm, I can stretch. If I want to contract my arm, I can contract. Means these muscles are under my control. So such a muscles are called as a voluntary muscle. Am I right? So this such muscles are called as a voluntary muscles. If I want to walk, I can walk with this my leg. Am I right? So these muscles are under my control. So such muscles are called as a voluntary muscles. Then next is involuntary muscle. For example, involuntary muscles means what? Now see, whenever you are having your food, it gets digested. Am I right? The process under the stomach is continuously working. Yes or no? So whether they are under our control? No. They are not under control. So such muscles are called as a involuntary muscles. Such muscles are called as a involuntary muscles. Means the muscles which are not under our control, such muscles are called as a involuntary muscles. Are you getting this? Then the last, third type of the muscles is cardiac muscle, which is present in our heart. Which is present in our walls of the heart. Now if you will see, our heart is working day and night. Whether it take rest? No. Yes or no? It does not take a rest. So cardiac muscles is present in our walls of the heart, which is continuously working. Now you only just tell me whether the working of the heart is under our control? No, it is not under our control. So this muscle is also not under our control. But this muscles works and this muscles work throughout our life. The cardiac muscles work throughout our life. I hope you have understood about the muscles and its types. So today's work is that you have to write the types of muscles and how many muscles are found in our body. That also you have to write in your science.